Hello, I'm Darren Magee, and today's question asks if I would discuss complex post-traumatic stress disorder, sometimes referred to as complex PTSD or CPTSD. In this video, I'm going to look at what it is. I'm going to look at the difference between that and PTSD. I'm also going to look at some of the common causes and some of the common symptoms, as well as some ideas for treatment. But just to remind you, this video is for information purposes only. Now, the term post-traumatic stress disorder was first used regarding the traumatic responses experienced by combat veterans, but it has since been recognized it can be experienced by anyone who's been exposed to any kind of traumatic events, such as natural disasters, accidents, acts of violence, or near-death experiences. And although the term complex PTSD was first used in the 1980s, it's not recognized by DSM-5 as a distinct condition. It is, however, recognized by the World Health Organization, and is in the ICD-11. Now, either way, many mental health professionals do recognize it as a separate condition, because the typical symptoms of PTSD don't always capture the characteristics that are shown by people who have experienced long-term, repeated, multiple trauma. Whereas PTSD can develop as a result of an isolated incident, with complex trauma, what we see is the underlying trauma or series of traumas have been repeated or have been ongoing. The situations or events have continued over months, sometimes even years. It is also believed that complex PTSD can be more severe whenever the traumatic events happen in early life. Now, common causes in childhood could include neglect, abuse, witnessing or experiencing domestic violence, abandonment or bullying. That being said, it can happen in adult life as well. Those same things could happen. As adults, we can be manipulated, coerced, assaulted and abused. Regardless though, in most cases, the trauma takes place whenever someone is under the control of another person or people, and they are unable to either escape or to defend themselves. Now, human beings, we are social creatures. We are hardwired for connection to others, and trauma disconnects us. So what can add to it being complex and multi-layered, what can further compound the trauma, the disconnection, is whenever the abuser or abusers was someone the person knew, someone they trusted, someone they were supposed to feel safe with. For example, a parent, a caregiver, a partner, could be someone in a position of responsibility, could be part of a group, maybe a religious group or an organization of some kind. It is even further exacerbated when that person or that group is maybe still around today and maybe there still has to be contact with them. Now, if that person maybe tried to address it, do something about it, maybe they weren't believed or perhaps were even blamed for their own abuse, this can further reinforce or compound the symptoms. So just like with PTSD, many people with complex trauma can experience flashbacks, re-experience, hyperarousal, hypervigilance, and avoidance. But some of the common symptoms of complex PTSD include, first of all, a negative self-view of themselves. Now, that person may feel guilty or ashamed of what they experienced. They may see themselves as bad, lose trust in others, treat others with caution, and feel separated. They may compare themselves unfavorably to others and perhaps judge themselves harshly. They may see the perpetrator or the perpetrators as being much more powerful than they are. They see themselves as perhaps weak and helpless, and some may even fantasize about revenge. There can be difficulty with the relationships, now be them romantic relationships, friendships, working relationships, and this is often due to difficulties in being able to trust. They can find it difficult to get close to someone or to allow others to get close to them. They may avoid relationships altogether, cut themselves off from the rest of the world. They can have difficulty in being able to control their emotions. Now, if provoked, they may either explode in anger or they may internalize it, withdraw into themselves. And many experience a persistent sadness, depression, and sometimes even suicidal thoughts. And other people may not necessarily know what's going on due to the person perhaps finding it difficult to articulate or maybe not fully understanding it themselves. many experience a detachment from the trauma. Now, this is known as dissociation, and this can happen in different ways. Now, a person may disconnect from themselves, and that's known as depersonalization. Or they may disconnect from the world around them, and this is known as derealization. But one way or another, their attention is disrupted. They are no longer in this moment. Some might even forget their trauma. It becomes buried. However, the emotional and the physical memories are still there. And many times, the emotional and the physical reactions happen when they're reminded of the trauma, commonly referred to as being triggered. Now, a trigger is something external. It's a sensory thing. It's a sight, a sound, a touch, a taste, a smell. What that brings up is an emotional or a physical memory. The person feels just like they did back then, just like they did during that time. It's like yesterday's threat, yesterday's situation is present today. Some people with complex PTSD, they engage in risk-taking or destructive behaviors such as alcohol or drug use or self-harm. This is often a way of either numbing or maybe escaping the pain. There are also physical symptoms such as dizziness, chest pains, headaches, stomach pains. There's tension in the muscles. There's a constant fatigue. There can also be a change in core values, core beliefs. Now, the belief system becomes distorted. We evaluate the world around us through what we believe. For example, if someone believes the world is a dangerous place as opposed to can be a dangerous place, then they will tend to evaluate everything as a potential threat, a potential risk. Other distorted beliefs could be things like everybody else is much more powerful than me, nothing ever works out for me, or I am bad. Now, treatment for complex PTSD can include medication. That medication can help reduce the symptoms of the anxiety and the depression. Trauma-focused CBT focuses on identifying the traumatic events, the negative thought patterns, and replacing them with more realistic, balanced ones. It can also help build resilience and confidence. Psychodynamic therapy can be helpful in the sense that someone learns more about themselves. They learn about their relationship with themselves as well as their relationship with others. They can learn to make better lifestyle choices and build healthier relationships with people. Many people find eye movement desensitization and reprocessing, or EMDR. That's really hard to say. I'd rather just say EMDR. They find that useful to help process and reframe traumatic memories. Regardless of the approach, the person can learn to be a bit more present, to be a bit more in the moment, and to problem solve situations. And these different approaches as well can help people relieve the symptoms of other mental health difficulties, especially those that are intertwined with the previous traumas. Again, think of the term complex. Now, I'm going to leave you with one of my favorite quotes from Carl Jung. I am not what happened to me. I am what I choose to become. And I'd be interested in your thoughts on that quote. But as always, if there's anything I've missed, please feel free to add to the comment box below. There are some interesting conversations started around these videos. And if you found this video interesting or helpful, please consider subscribing to my channel for future updates on mental health related topics. And until next time, thanks for watching.